to seek your face and to seek your kingdom. Oh Lord, reveal your ways to me. To be sensitive to your voice, to every whisper, every roar of your voice. Oh, 'cause I don't wanna miss a thing. I don't wanna miss anything you say or do. Don't let me miss a thing. Don't let me miss a beat. I'm here to hear from you. Don't let me miss a thing. Don't let me miss a beat. I'm here to hear from you. Don't let me miss a thing. Don't let the more I seek you, the more I find you. The more I find you, the more I love you. The more I seek you, the more I find you. The more I find you, oh, oh, oh. The more I love you. Now drink from the cup in your hands, lay back against you and breathe. Feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I melt in your peace, it's overwhelming. I wanna sit at your feet, Drink from the cup in your hands. Lay back again to and breathe. Feel your heart beat. This love is so deep. It's more than I can stand. I melt in your peace. It's so more than I can stand. I melt in your peace, it's overwhelming. This love is so deep, it's more than me more in a moment than other lovers could in a lifetime. You could love me more in a moment than other lovers could in a lifetime. You could love me more in a moment than other lovers could in a lifetime. You could love me more in a moment than other lovers could in a lifetime. You could love me more in a moment than other lovers could in a lifetime. You could love me more in a moment than other lovers could in a lifetime. You could love me more in a moment than other lovers could in a lifetime. You could love me more in a moment than other lovers could in a lifetime. So let me love you more. Enter in me, a love that's deep, a love that's wild, a love that's sweet. And help me, Lord, to never keep it to myself. And if my heart should dimly burn, and if my feet should fail to run, call my name and I can run right back to you. Stir in me a love that's deep, a love that's wild, a love that's sweet. And help me, Lord, to never keep it to myself. And if my heart should dimly burn, and if my feet should fail to run, call my name and I can run right back to you.
Transition into a time of worshiping the Word. This morning we'll be worshiping from Psalm 42, verse 1 through 11. Again, the passage is Psalm 42, verse 1 to 11. So I encourage you to open up your Bibles and follow along. Psalm 42, verse 1. As a deer pants for the flowing streams, so pants my soul for you, O God. My soul thirsts for you, God, for the living God. God, this is our confession today, that we need you. We need your presence here in this place. Fill this place with your presence, God. As a deer pants for flowing streams, our soul longs only for you. We cannot live without you, God. We need to see you. We need to hear your voice. Lord, we are dry and weary. Our strength is withering away. We are thirsty and hungry for more of you. Without your streams of living water, we can't quench our own thirst in this world. We need your living water, God. Only you can fill us. Give us a thirst for you alone. As the darkness becomes darker in this world, give us a deeper thirst for your presence. Fill us with desperation to know the truth of your living word. We cling unto you for our lives. Give us your living water. Quench our thirst in you, God. Only you can give us a life abundant. We look to you as our provider and the one and only living God.
See it through. You're the one who makes me thirsty. desperate. Lord, I'm desperate for you. And let me be desperate. Let me be desperate for you. Let me be desperate. Let me be desperate for you. Let me be desperate. Let me be desperate for you. Let me be desperate. Let me be desperate for you. Let me be desperate. Let me be desperate for you. Dangerous prayer. Oh, a dangerous prayer. I know that when I ask to be desperate, when I ask to be hungry, you lead me. Oh, you lead me. Situations and circumstances that are not easy, that are not easy. Oh, but how I long to know you and love you through it all. To know you. Love you more through it all. Holy desperation breeds righteousness. Holy desperation leads to holiness. Holy desperation breeds righteousness. Holy desperation leads to holiness. Holy desperation breeds righteousness. Holy desperation leads to holiness. Holy desperation breeds righteousness. Holy desperation leads to holiness. Oh, I want to be holy as you are holy. I long to be holy.
142, verse 5. Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you in turmoil within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise Him, my salvation and my God. My soul is cast down within me. Therefore, I remember you from the land of Jordan and of Hermon, from Mount Mazar. Father, you are our hope in times of distress. When we walk through seasons of turmoil, when it's dark, when it's hard to find you, we remember your deeds and your word. You are the one who saved Israel from the hands of Pharaoh, delivered them out of Egypt. You led them towards the promised land with a pillar of cloud and fire. Even when they turned against you, you were patient in showing your mercy and your love. And you sent your one and only Son, Jesus, to die for us. That you made a way for us to live in eternity with you. We choose to remember what you've done for us today. We remember how you took away our sins and healed us. Remember your promises to never leave us. We remember, so we hope in you. Let us not forget who you are, Lord. We want to hold on to the joy of knowing you, God. We remember and hope in your unchanging character. We praise you, our hope and our salvation.
I will remember all my days. I will remember who you are. I will remember the salvation you brought to me. Why are you cast down? Oh my soul, oh my soul, rise up and remember, rise up and praise the Lord, for He is good, He is faithful, He is worthy to hope in, He is worthy to trust in, oh He is always good. Hope in God, my salvation. My soul,
you're the hope, you're the salvation, you're the hope, you're the salvation.
Jesus Christ, who crucified, Jesus Christ, now and I will honor him with all I am.
As a deer long for your streams, as a deer long for the waters, my soul longs for you, God. My soul
see what
Thank you, God, for the hope that we can have in you. We will remember the cross. We will remember what you have done for us. We won't forget your love, Jesus. Give us holy desperation. Give us the desire to seek your holiness. Fill us, God. Fill our thirst in your living word. In Jesus' name, amen.
There's just one chief and two men's purpose. One main reason for existence. All men's vain and high ambitions will one day be brought.
Put your glory in me. I'll serve anyone.
All that you do. just part of you. I don't want to love the parts that are easy to love. I don't want to love just part of you. Oh, I don't want to love the parts that are easy to love. Oh, help me love all of you. Help me love.
God, it is our joy. It is our delight to be in your presence. We give you all the glory. Take us deeper in your word. In Jesus' name, amen. We will now continue with the word, worshiping in the word. Please turn with me in your Bibles to Psalm 42, verse 7 to 11. So that's Psalm 42, verse 7 to 11. Psalm 42, verse 7. Deep calls to deep at the roar of your waterfalls. All your breakers and your waves have gone over me. By day the Lord commands his steadfast love, and at night his song is with me, a prayer to the God of my life. Father, you are always with us in times of suffering and uncertainty. Even when we feel like drowning under the waves of this world, you have never let go. Your hand has carried us through and through. As time draws closer to your return, we've heard of the waves of affliction and persecution. But we are not afraid because you are with us. We will not be overwhelmed by the world's darkness, but trust in your steadfast love. Because there is no fear in love. There is no fear in your love. Your love covers us day and night. Because of your unchanging love, we trust you as our sole guide. Use your love to discipline and strengthen us, God. Give us ears to discern your voice, eyes to see your spirit moving on this earth. Set us apart with your love as we draw near to the last days.
Trust in your steadfast love and your faithful love. My love and yours forever, God. Your love and yours forever. Of
No room for fear in me. Your steadfast love leaves no room for fear in me. Your steadfast love, oh God, leaves no room for in me. Your steadfast love leaves no room for fear in me. For your steadfast love leaves no room for fear. Steadfast love leaves no room for fear in me. So I will trust, so I will trust. I choose to trust, I choose to trust. I choose to trust you. Oh, I choose to trust you.
Psalm 42, verse 9. I say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why do I go mourning because of the oppression of the enemy? As with a deadly wound in my bones, my adversaries taunt me, while they say to me all day long, where is your God? Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you in turmoil within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise Him, my salvation and my God. God, we know that our minds and bodies are weak. We confess that when we face the oppression of the enemy, sometimes we forget who you are. We are overcome by our own pain to see who you truly are. But we say to you now, you are our rock. You are our ultimate strength, a movable foundation in our lives. You are the one we can put our trust in no matter what. When we are weak, you are strong. And we hope in you, God. Hope in you never disappoints. You will judge our enemies. You are faithful to your words and promises. Thank you, Jesus, for you have risen above and was victorious over death. We praise you as our King. You are worthy to be praised forever. We put our faith and hope in you, our God, our salvation.
Worthy. Even in the wilderness, God, even in the blindness and darkness, we will praise your name, for your name is a rock. We will praise your name. Such as one, your characteristics never change. In our eyes, God, many things happening, many things that distract us.
Us unmovable from hoping in you. You are our God, whom we trust. In Jesus' name, amen.
Draw near to me, for I have drawn near to you. Pull on the strings of my heart, for I long to respond to you. Come on, come on.
Heavenly Father, we come into your presence right now, and we ask for your Holy Spirit to reveal to us the weight of your heart for the nations, especially for America. Awake us to pray out of the heaviness of your heart. We refuse to speak empty words. We want to cry out from the depths of your heart right now. Holy Spirit, lead us into intercession. In Jesus' name, amen. We will now transition into a time of intercession for the Church of America. Please come into agreement with me as I lead these prayer topics and follow my prayer with your own intercession. Father God, we thank you that you love your church so much. Thank you for giving us your word of warning to prepare us for what is coming. It's not right to see your church in America be in darkness any longer. Thank you for calling them to wake up from their sleep. Shake your church in America. Wake them up with sudden fear that comes only from you. Let your anguish against injustice be released in your church. Break their complacency. Open their eyes to see the evil rampaging in the land of America. Do not let their heart grow harder. Do not let them be disillusioned by their fleshy desire. Reveal your anger towards abortion and all the blood of babies crying out. Let your anger towards sex trafficking and discrimination towards black community be revealed to your church. Let the blood of martyrs cry out to your church in America. Wake up, church! Wake up now and listen to the Holy Spirit calling to you to get out of your slumber. The hour is already here. Do not fall into darkness. Awake and cry out for your nation, for America. Let's pray. Thank you.
wake up, oh church, wake up, oh watchman, wake up, for the time is now. Wake up, oh church, wake up, oh watchman, wake up, oh church, for the time is now. Wake up, oh church, wake up, oh watchman, wake up, oh church, for the time is now. Wake up, oh church, wake up, oh watchman, wake up, oh church, for the time is now. Wake up, oh church, wake up, oh watchman, wake up, oh church, for the time is now. Wake up, oh church, wake up, oh watchman, wake up, oh church, for the time is now.
God, we come to you and repent. We repent on behalf of American church. We confess that the church has turned away from you, made idols in their hearts and worshiped them. We repent of sexual immorality and the love of money in the church. We ask for forgiveness on behalf of leaders who has abused their authority to hurt your precious children. Please forgive us of watering down your word and being ignorant and passive about truth of your second coming. Please show your mercy and grace to the church in America so they can abandon their idols completely. Renew their minds, renew their hearts, God, to seek holiness and righteousness. Let those who don't turn away from their idolatry fall into darkness, but have mercy. Mercy, God, so those who are awakened can still turn to you. We pray for you to purify your church in America at this hour. Let's pray. Thank you.
back your place as first in their hearts. Take back their place. Oh, take back your place as first in their hearts. Take back your place, oh God. Take back your place as first in their hearts. Take back your place, oh God. Take back your place as first in their hearts. Take back your place, oh God. Take back your place as first in their hearts. Take back your place, oh God.
Take back what's yours, God.
Take back your place as first in their hearts. Take back your place, oh God. Take back your place as first in their hearts. Take back your place, oh God. Take back your place as first in their hearts. Take back your place, oh God. Take back your place as first in their hearts. Take back your place, oh God. Let them fear you. Take back your place as first in their heart. Take back your place, oh
Word. Thank you for warning us to watch and be ready. We ask for you to prepare the American church to be like the five wise virgins, ready with their lamp and oil. Give them strength to stay awake and be watchful of the signs and warnings you're releasing at this hour for America. Unveil the truth in your word, the promises of blessing and judgment you spoke to Israel. Let them see that the same promise is still being fulfilled right now. Let your church understand your truth and righteousness in fulfilling your word. Raise up your watchmen, those who will watch day and night and cry out for the nation of America. Raise up your watchmen who are bold in speaking your judgment and wrath, filled by the Spirit and interceding for the nation. Raise up your watchmen in the Church of America. Let's pray.
Thank you.
Father, as the world gets darker towards your return, let the light of your church shine brighter in America. We don't want your church to be hidden away. We prophesy over the American church. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Arise and shine. We declare your church as a radiant bride. We declare no fear, but boldness and courage to stand as light in the darkness. A church that is not afraid to speak the truth of your judgment and warn America to not hide their faces any longer, but to raise up, speak about the glory of your return. We pray that many will see the light of your church shining brightly and turn back to you from their sin. Lord, release your mercy and grace in America to return to you as their everlasting light. Release your mercy and grace for them to hear and repent and respond to your gospel. Glorify your church at this hour. Lord, arise upon your church. Let your glory be seen upon the Church of America. Let's pray. Yes, God, thank you for warning your church in America because you love them so much, because you don't want to see anyone perish. Thank you for showing your mercy for them to wake up and repent and awake, awake and arise, your watchmen in this hour, to speak your truth with clarity and power. Let your church shine and be glorified at this hour. In Jesus' name, amen.
Jesus be glorified. Jesus be lifted high. Let every tongue confess, every knee shall bow. Say that you are the King. We exalt you. There is no other name like you. No other like you. You are holy. You are holy, God. God, we thank you that you allow us to enter into your presence, that you've made a way for us to
enter freely. We thank you, Lord, that you poured out your wrath upon the cross so that we wouldn't have to take God. I thank you, Lord, that you have spared us, and not just spared us, but given us abundant and eternal life. Lord, may the weight of your glory settle in our hearts. May the weight of salvation, may the weight of your wrath and judgment, your mercy, your justice, settle deep in our hearts, God. We want to know you and love you in your fullness. So let us love you more, Jesus. We honor you this morning. Thanks for joining us this morning. Hope that the Lord spoke to you and revealed some things. It's always a joy and an honor to have you guys here on Wednesday mornings. So we're glad you joined us. And we hope that you continue to pray into current events and pray for America. Yeah, really just seek God's heart. And pray his heart out. So, we thank you for joining us, and we hope to see you again next week.